Hi everyone. Today we discuss about power factor and power triangle. This is where many gets confused due to the angles involved in between sinusoidal curves. Initially we need to know the power types involved in electrical equipment. First one is the active power, denoted by P and measured in kilowatts. Secondly it is reactive power, denoted by Q and measured in kVars. Here, meaning of simple R after kVA is to show that it is reactive power. Third one is apparent power, denoted by S and measured in kilovolt ampere. Then, you get this equation, power factor equals active power divided by apparent power. This shows that active power is part of all factor of the apparent power. When the two powers are with same value, the factor becomes 1. Then what is reactive power? When the coils of inductive loads get energized, windings of motors get heated, capacitors on circuits get charged, there will be additional requirement of energy other than the main requirement of power to operate electrical equipment. We can't introduce this power as waste of energy. It is part of energy used for auxiliary work during the operation of the main equipment and is called reactive power. Reactive power need to be kept to a minimum level during designing of electrical equipment to make sure the power factor is within the range of reasonable acceptable value between 0.8 and 1. Power factor is also called as cost phi, and you will have seen this on nameplates of induction motors, generators, or on any other relevant electrical equipment. Power factor can have values from 0 to 1 mathematically, but any electrical equipment having power factor below 0.8 will not be economical to use. Power factor can go below 0 in special conditions, but not discussed here. Let's see how the power triangle works now. Green horizontal straight line shows active power here. Reactive power in red acts perpendicular to the active power. You will see that these two powers act within the electrical equipment, and the actual resultant power required from the main power supply to iron it out is called the apparent power. According to the size of the reactive power, there is an angle between the active power and the apparent power, and is called phi in degrees. When angle phi is at 45 degrees, value of cos phi or power factor is 0.71. You can get the value of cos 45 by using calculator or any other mean. When angle phi is at 30 degrees, value of cos 30 or power factor is 0.87. You will see that an angle of 30 degrees for cos phi is acceptable for an electrical equipment since it has the power factor value of 0.87 now and has passed the general acceptance level of 0.8 for power factor. Same way, when angle phi is at 20 degrees, value at cos 20 or power factor becomes 0.94. When the angle phi becomes 10 degrees, value at cos phi or power factor reaches 0.98, and you will see that the apparent power is closer to the active power line now, and the size 2 is getting closer to the size of the active power line. When angle phi is at 0 degrees, value at cos phi or power factor reaches the value at 1. Although I have drawn the apparent power line with a gap to show it to you, it is right on top of the active power line now. Further, apparent power line has the same length as of the active power line. It means apparent power, S, equals active power, P, and is when the reactive power value drops to the zero level. When solving problems related to the power factor, you need to know about the Pythagoras theorem, and here is just a reminder on it. It says, on a right-angled triangle, square value of the hypotenuse, that is opposite side leg of the right angle, is equal to the sum of the square values of the other two sides. Here on our power triangle, S is the opposite side of the right angle. Then, Q squared plus P squared equals S squared. When you take P squared to the other side, final outcome shows Q equals to the square root of S squared minus P squared. Let's see what the phase angle between voltage and current is. When the voltage curve and the current curve have no difference in angles, it is called that the both current and voltage curves are in phase. Here, both curves start at the same time from zero value, get their peak value at 90 degrees, come to their lowest point at 270 degrees, and finish on zero value at 360 degrees. When the voltage and current waves are in phase, it is special because the power factor value at this point is 1. This is when the total load is pure resistive. Since the angle difference is 0 here, cos phi or power factor is 1. Also, reactive power Q equals 0. Hence active power P equals apparent power S. Let's see what happens to the voltage and current curves when there is an angle difference between them. Here, the current sine wave starts phi angle later, after the voltage curve starts. This is the situation where the voltage and current waves are at out of phase. When the circuit is with an inductive load, current wave behaves like this and shifts with an angle to the right. Here, current lags behind the voltage by phi angle. Although it seems to be the current wave is in front on the diagram, it started phi angle later, after the voltage curve started from 0 first, hence is the lagging one. Reactive power Q involves here and interferes to move apparent power S higher than the active power P now. Power factor or cos phi value here is less than 1 and depends on the shifted angle. Now we will find the solution for an example. What will be the apparent power S in kilovolt ampere and reactive power Q in kVAR when the nameplate of a three-phase induction motor shows 10 kilowatt, 400 volt and cos phi equals 0.85? These are the two equations to be used here. Power factor equals active power divided by apparent power. When arranged to get apparent power to the left side, it equals active power divided by power factor. P is the value given on the motor nameplate with kilowatt, and the power factor 2 is given on the nameplate. When 10 is divided by 0.8, we get 11.76 kilovolt ampere for apparent power, S. This 11.76 kilovolt ampere is what we require from the electricity company to operate this 10 kilowatt motor. To find reactive power, Q, we will deduct square of P from square of S first. Square of 11.76 is 138.29, and square of 10 is 100. By subtracting, you get 38.29, and the square root of it is the value of Q. So, 6.2 kVAR is the reactive power here in this motor. Supplying this reactive power 6.2 kVAR value from a separate capacitor is simply what is meant by installing a capacitor bank. Hope you got fair idea about the power factor and power triangle now. If you think that this video is helpful, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.